Okay, we're gonna play you one more song for this half. That's right, isn't it, Jacob? Actually, meet Jacob Stoney. On the keyboard table. And this behind me, this is Matthew Downer playing the bass for you. I ought to get it in tune or the next 7 minutes are going to be really uncomfortable. So yeah, so the album Upsetter is an album of story songs, like I said, and I wanted to include some new stories on there. And I'm a big listener to podcasts at the moment, and I heard a podcast with an interview with a lady called Anne Druyan, who was a junior member of the team, along with later her husband Carl Sagan, who put together a golden record that was sent aboard the Voyager 1 and 2 spacecrafts. And she told the story that's in this song. Every single word of this song is completely true. And Voyager 1 and 2 are the furthest man-made objects from Earth. And the record that's aboard them is plated with gold and is labelled The Sounds of Earth. So it contains various sounds that they collected to represent all of humanity. And I suppose how much there's more that makes us the same than divides us. So we're going to listen to some of those sounds first, and then we'll play the song. So this is called The Sounds of Earth.
Jeg fik dig i fly en avle af kommunser. Hvor jo du måne? Af Danish du schulen. Hvis man lader sig til du måtte og nærmere, ikke der
bliver til at sætte til en anden kommunser. Hello from the children of planet Earth.
Hidden on a printout that he hadn't seen before. At the lab of Pasadena, he fed the numbers in of 100 possibilities, but this could be the one. 'Cause there was gonna be a moment when the planets were aligned, a moment in their orbits when they all came to inside. Travel like a slingshot, use the gravity to steer. Another chance won't come again for full 200 years. God, I'll leave you exactly how a tale should be told, how an idea could be broken, how a story could be sold. He says that to send a message to whoever finds it first, to tell them that we come in peace. Let's send the sounds of earth. So we made a list of all the sounds that sum up who we are, a mixtape of humanity to travel through the stars. Gathered up his team, Linda, Frank and John and Timothy, and last of all there's Anne. Stravinsky, Bach and Mozart and 50s rock and roll, the crying of a baby and the calling of the whale. Dogs and rain and laughter and the singing of the birds, diagrams and images, maps of all the earth. 'Cause they say there is a kind of spirit music in the world that plays for all eternity as round the sun it's hurled. If we could preserve it on a record made of gold, it could last a billion years. Oh, oh, oh. she was so diligent and she was so keen. She searched among the archives just to find the missing piece. Out a print recording of an ancient Chinese lute. All their hopes were resting on discovering this tune. Well, one night she called to tell him that she'd found the flowing streams. Called but found he wasn't home, so played it into his machine. Said, "Dad, I found the missing piece, I think I've found our song." Says, "Carl, it's good to hear your voice. I've been waiting for so long. Cause I've been waiting for the moment when the planets would align. Waiting for the feeling, waiting for a sign. They talk for hours until the sun came glistening all the sea. As the dawn was breaking, he says, Annie, marry me." The machines attached the sensors to his skin to record her EEG. As soon as they had started, she knew what she should do. The sound of someone falling in love. All the time I thought of you. When the voyagers were ready to be sent upon their way, and a golden record's mounted with a needle to make it play. They launched them in September for Cape Canaveral, the furthest man-made objects, they're out there moving still. So beyond our solar system, there's a golden calling card. Inscribed, "Please don't disturb me, let me travel to the stars. Someday someone finds it, they'll hear the sound of love that could last a billion years or more."
Thank you very much.